Starting a social media marketing agency is probably one of the fastest ways to create a full-time income online. And today, I'm going to show you how. I dislike YouTube intros as much as you, but make sure you leave a like on the video, subscribe if you're new, and grab my free Instagram ebook down in the top link of the description. So first things first, you're going to need a service, as some sort of skill that you can sell to businesses. You could do photography for local business Instagram / Facebook pages. You could do graphic design for theme pages or personal brands. You can do growth for people on social media. You can be a closer that's closing deals for people on social media. Or you can help businesses manage their paid ads to generate more sales for their business. There are a whole range of different services you can specialize depending on what you enjoy most and what area you may or may not already have skills in. I'd pick one based on what you most enjoy. Then what I want you to do is head over to this very, very secret website. It's on the internet. It's called youtube.com. Probably haven't heard of it, but it's a site where you can basically learn anything you want if you're willing to go and do the research, watch a few videos, take some notes, etc. If you're struggling to find good tutorials on YouTube, where considering pretty much everything is on there, then you can head over to sites like Skillshare or Udemy, where they give you like a free trial for a couple months and you can pretty much learn any skill you want through those, or maybe get a few cheap paid courses. And what this is going to help you do is learn a specific skill, whatever it might be, whatever that you wanted to go into. There's a bunch of different things, like I mentioned before, but pick one of these, go to one of these sites, learn the skill. I personally prefer go for like quite a specific skill. For example, my Instagram agency, we do growth for entrepreneurs. So I've got a big network of entrepreneurial pages on Instagram, and then clients come to us and we basically get them ads on a ton of these large pages, which grows their audience. And because I've got that network, we can get bulk rates. We know what ads are going to work, and therefore I've got a big client base in one niche, which means I get more referrals and so on. And it's easier to fulfill a bunch of clients for the same service than a bunch of clients for different services. Okay, moving on to step two. Now that you have a service, you need a case study or a testimonial of your work. You also need a bit of experience. What you want to do is go out there and identify who your dream client is. Like, what sort of business are you looking for? Are you looking for authors who want to get their book out there to more people? Are you looking for local dentists who are trying to get more people into their clinic? Are you working with online fitness coaches that are trying to get more clients online? Identify who that ideal client is and then find them on Instagram and DM 10 to 20 of them every single day. DM or email, both work pretty well. And offer to do a free month of work or a free 2-week trial of work with no expectations after it, no like contract where they have to start paying you, just so you can get out there, you can put your skills into practice, you can see what's working, what's not working, and you can get this person results. And then you can take those results and show them to future clients rather than just going out there without any past results and trying to close someone for thousands of dollars. This way you can not only test your skills, but you can get a case study entirely free, which like I mentioned, you can then go and show to other businesses. Because if you work for this person for free and you do Facebook ads for them, let's say, and you spend $500 on ads for them and you generate them back $5,000 in sales and you go show that to other businesses, any business owner would be willing to pay you to do that because that's a pretty awesome return. However, if you haven't put your skills into practice, you don't fully know what you're capable of, it's a bit of a risk for a business owner to put $500 into ads and pay you whatever your fee is upfront if they've got no clue what you're capable of doing, which is why I always recommend do some free work at the start. I did that, it worked for me, and I know a lot of other people in the niche that do pretty well off an actual agency and that have done the same thing. Third is go get some paying clients. Go DM businesses, get on the phone with them, send them some emails, show them the results that you're capable of for similar businesses to theirs, show them what you're charging, and then basically close the deal. Now, I always get the question, like, how much should I charge? Where should I price my stuff? And my recommendation, and you can take this if you want, or you can do your own thing, but is to go below the market at the start, and then as you start building up a bigger portfolio of clients, you can increase your price accordingly. If you start below the market, it's a good way to get your foot in the door, get a few clients that are maybe paying you a $500 a month rather than $1,000 or $1,500, which I know a lot of people charge. So if you go a bit cheaper, you're more likely to get a couple clients at the start, which is going to give you more experience and get you better at what you do. And if you get them good results, that's likely to lead to referrals. Then as you start getting more clients coming in, you're getting better at what you do, and you're getting overworked, you can increase your prices to maybe get rid of a couple of your clients, and then you find that nice equilibrium where you're charging a good amount, but you've got enough clients at the same time. For example, if you start out charging $500 per client and then you eventually build up to 10 clients and you just can't handle 10, you could then start charging 1,000, and maybe only half the businesses are gonna stick with you. That's cool, but you're making the exact same amount of money. 10 times 500 is 5,000, 5 times 1,000 is 5,000. So you're getting the same amount of money with half the clients. And then as you get better, maybe you get back to 10 clients and then maybe you start charging more again, and so on. Now, aside from cold DMs and emails, the other best way to get clients is through sites like Upwork and Fiverr. I would probably avoid Fiverr if you're looking to do high level stuff, as usually it's ranging from stuff from like $5 to $100. There are higher ticket services on there, but sites like Upwork, you can easily get gigs that'll pay $30, $40, $50 an hour. Now, step four, now that you've got a client or two, focus on getting them amazing results. This way, they're more likely to stay with you, meaning you don't have to constantly replace your clients every month, but they're also more likely to give you referrals, which are the easiest clients by far to close, is if someone's been referred by their friend to come and work with you, because they've already seen what you did for their friend, they trust their friend, they trust their recommendation, and it's very, very easy to close. So if you can focus on getting amazing results, you might not even need to do outreach after a few months because you just work off referrals. So make sure you focus on keeping them happy, because in the long run, it'll save you a lot of time, it'll make you way more money, and you'll be much happier. Repeat clients and referred clients are by far the most profitable, in my opinion, for when you're doing this sort of stuff. And lastly, step number five is stay consistent. And I say this in every video, regardless of what I'm talking about, but it is super important. Constantly improve on your skill set. Constantly be delivering for your clients. Constantly be reaching out to new businesses as long as you need more. Constantly keep working on your business, working on with contractors or employees or whatever it is, and don't give up if you don't get results straight away, because at the end of the day, it's not going to happen overnight. And if it did, then you'd have millions of people doing this. It takes time, it takes effort, but it's definitely worth it, in my opinion, in the long run. So to wrap things up, let's go over a quick recap of how you can start a social media marketing agency in 2020, which is by far going to be probably the fastest way to build a full-time income. It's probably one of the slowest ways to scale, one of the hardest business models to scale, like to bigger numbers, as I'm starting to realize myself. But to get to like 3,000, 4,000, 5,000, probably the easiest model. First things first, you're gonna need a skill or a service. Second, now that you have a skill, you're gonna need some experience and a case study. So go out there and do some work for free for a business. Third, go get yourself some paying clients who are gonna pay you every single month. Leverage that case study, leverage potentially referrals, and go get it. Fourth, focus massively on looking after your clients so they not only stay, but they also refer their friends. And fifth is stay super consistent. I say it every single time, but basically continue learning, continue upskilling yourself, continue delivering for clients. It won't happen overnight, nothing will, but if you stick at it for the long run, you'll smash it. So I hope this video helps you start your agency in 2020 if that's something you want to get into. Make sure, as always, if you enjoyed the video, leave a like, subscribe if you are new, and you can grab my free Instagram ebook in the top link of the description down below. And yeah, that's it from me. See you guys in another video sometime soon.